How's it going? I'm Adam. I'm the CEO and founder of Voyurl. That's Mike, our CTO and co-founder. I promised my mom I'd take a photo. Cool. So we're a group of folks, a small team, in New York and California and in Ohio, with backgrounds in digital marketing, bioinformatics, big data, and even front-end design. And while you guys are all on your laptops right now, typing away and tweeting and emailing, first thing you should be is emailing me.
It's adam@voyurl.com.
But also, you guys probably know this, but a lot of people don't. You're being tracked and followed all over the place right now. That's why you're getting optimized ads in your Gmail. That's why you're getting sponsored tweets in your streams. And frankly, we were all really unhappy with the way our behavioral data has been treated online. So we decided to create a new way to handle that behavioral data. And that's why we built Voyurl. So Voyurl helps you optimize and quantify your browsing behavior. And it also uses that information to fuel content discovery. So we show you cool new stuff about the things you love online. Sort of like how Mint.com or Fitbit helps you quantify your daily life and get recommendations, except ours is completely effortless. It's effortless because we think people are sick of feedback fatigue. We're constantly plussing and minusing and rating all of our content. And I don't know about you guys, but my platforms still get me pretty wrong. And at the same time, we're churning through tons of data. The average user goes through about 2,500 links a month. And on top of that, about 25 million or more are shared socially every day. So that told us three really important things. First off, we're going through an insane amount of content, probably more than we could ever handle. And on top of that, we're doing a lot of work evaluating all of that content for our platforms to still not get us right. And finally, just by doing all that stuff, this is the most important for us, we're throwing off a tremendous volume of data exhaust. It's really, really valuable, and yet we never get to look at it or tap into it or see it. It's always been kept from us. And that's because these three pieces have been kept separate. But Voyurl actually merges these three pieces to simultaneously eliminate steps, give you your data back, and make it work for you without making it without requiring any work from you. Sorry. So what you do is step one. You download our browser plugin. You can show it to you. It's up in the right-hand corner. But that's it. It's the only thing you got to do. No step two, three, four. Just download the plugin, and you're good to go. And that's because we don't want any social networks, we don't need your Twitter authorizations, because we don't think your social graph is actually a good indicator of what content you should be recommended. In fact, we'd rather take the maxim that actions speak louder than words and apply it to your browsing behavior. And that's exactly what we analyze. So let's take a look at what Voyurl can do. When you log in, you get a dashboard, and this is what you're looking at now. And this is actually Mike's browsing behavior. Sorry, buddy, we're putting you on blast. Mike's browsing behavior on the left versus that of the overall user base on the right. And we do this so you can get a quick snapshot of how you're using the web. And this is a breakdown and allows you to get some differences and similarities and trends about how you're using the web. It's important to reiterate why we're doing this. It's because we actually believe that the data should be in the hands of the people who generate it, not in the hands of those who sell it. And also, we're understanding that the quantified self is becoming a more and more important part of our digital lives. So rather than keep this data for ourselves, we're actually giving it back to everybody. We're wrapping up in interesting and compelling ways to help you make sense of it and learn from it. So let's take a look at overall trends. This is actually a breakdown of how the whole user base is using the web, and everybody gets this. It shows you category snapshots of what categories are in. It gives you trend lines against time spent and visits. It gives you spark lines against your category engagement within different categories. There it is. And it even breaks down your browsing behavior by days of the week. So let's see what people are doing the most. So it looks like, is that Tuesday? Yeah, oddly, Tuesday is the most browsed day on the web. And you can see it's happening early in the morning. When everyone's getting to work. This is GMT, so it's a little bit later in the day. And we even break down your browsing behavior by day, by category, and then you can get into browsing flow if you want. So this is a really cool graph download. This actually details how everyone's moving around the web from category to category. And here's a really funny one that we found. Cats actually connect to everything on the web. It's kind of ridiculous. So you get these analytics for the whole user base, but you also get them for yourself. So you get My Trends as well. And My Trends are actually the same breakdowns, category snapshots, trend lines against user visits and time spent. You get the engagement by day a week. You get the category flow wheel. You get the whole shebang. And actually, this is all free right out of the box right when you sign up. You don't have to do anything but browse the web. That's it. No other feedback. And we're actually crunching all of this data, and it's all behavioral data, remember. So no social networks, no OAuths, no privacy issues. It's 100% secure and 100% yours to get you content feeds. Because we think if we can find out what you behave positively on, we can also find other people who behave like you and start recommending content to you that they've enjoyed that you've never seen. It's because we have access to the clickstream. So this is a uniquely tuned list of content made just for me, or actually just for Mike. Sorry, it's not my profile. And this is based on how he's been browsing around the web and his unique browsing behavior. And it's uniquely tuned and balanced and contextually tuned and balanced to how he's been browsing at any given time and any given day. It's done effortlessly, on the fly, for free, for him, all the time. And then finally, if you wanted to see how people are browsing across the user base, we give you what's hot. Same idea, it's what's trending across everyone who's using our browser plugin and our web service. And finally, if you wanted to accuse us of getting you deeper in the filter bubble, we actually built you a digital ejection seat. This is the anti-me button. It basically feeds you content 180 degrees away for how you've been behaving on the web. So if you ever get a little sick of what you've been looking at and you're like, oh, no more sports content, because I look at sports a lot, we'll feed you stuff all the way away from what you're doing. So just a few things that we're doing with some data exhaust. It's stuff that no one's ever gotten to see before from the consumer side. We're building some really cool B2B stuff that's coming shortly, and we've got some other new innovations to let people tap into it. So come see us over at booth D1. That's as many steps as it takes to set up Voyurl, just one. Thanks.